Hello and welcome to 5 Minute Matches. If this is your first time here, help the channel by clicking the subscribe button. On Friday, October 15th, 2021, Vince McMahon and Fox decided to do a special version of SmackDown. SmackDown was enlarged by 30 minutes airing without commercial breaks, causing SmackDown to directly compete with AEW's Friday night offering, Rampage. Tony Khan, the owner and CEO of AEW, who was always careful not to compete directly with the WWE, always chose different time slots to air his show, attempting to avoid splitting the audience. But when SmackDown decided to encroach on his time slot, Tony Khan saw the Vince McMahon move as a direct challenge to his show Rampage. Tony Khan arranged with his network TNT for the first half hour of Rampage to also be commercial free. On the WWE side, SmackDown was to be main evented by a non-title match between the returning Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch, along with the Brock Lesnar and Roman Reigns contract signing. Basically, the WWE added half an hour to their show to deliver the same old tired sh**, a lame contract signing and a non-title match that probably will have a screwy finisher.
Right into Belair. Oh, and Becky caught her with a right. And Bianca Belair! Sasha Banks, Belair with the assist!
Two rivalries with matches that have already happened multiple times for a number of years. Enticing television, indeed.
Life sucks, and then you die!
On AEW's side, they didn't try to reinvent the wheel. They gave the people CM Punk vs Matt Sydal in a great match, and it f***ing worked. Rampage was main evented by the Inner Circle going against America's top team, Ethan Page, Scorpio Sky, and Junior Dos Santos in his in-ring debut for AEW. This is where it gets interesting. Tony Khan, who is not one to take the hits lying down, decided to up the ante and respond to SmackDown's challenge. AEW would present us with a special treat, airing directly against the second hour of SmackDown. We pick up the Brian Suzuki match at 9:25 Eastern Standard Time. AEW airs a promo package showing Brian's accomplishments in his short time with AEW. Bryan Danielson is with AEW for slightly over a month, after a long and accomplished roller coaster of a ride with the WWE, where Bryan did the unthinkable and main evented WrestleMania, persevering against the WWE machine to become one of the greatest wrestlers ever. And despite having to retire for several years due to health issues and coming back stronger than ever, the WWE never gave Bryan the level of attention that he enjoyed before retiring temporarily. In the short time that Bryan Danielson has been with AEW, he has already proved himself as still being one of the greatest wrestlers in God's green earth, especially in that match of the year contender against Kenny Omega earlier this month. Back to the package, moments later, the King, the leader of Suzuki-gun, the most evil man in professional wrestling, Minoru Suzuki, makes his entrance showered in adoration by the AEW crowd. Side note, if you don't know or aren't familiar with Minoru Suzuki's work, you are missing out. I first saw Minoru Suzuki back in 2014 wrestling one of my favorites, AJ Styles, when they both competed at the G1 Climax 24 tournament. Both Minoru Suzuki and the G1 Climax are some of the best professional wrestling in the planet. And although these matches are hard to find in the wild, they are definitely worth the New Japan World subscription. Which, by the way, means become the wind. The American Dragon Daniel Bryan, Bryan Danielson follows.
Love what Bobby Fish is doing. Every single time you see Daniel Bryan's, Bryan Danielson, he's had, I'm just gonna call him American Dragon. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I hope I'm making you feel better because it's proven that it's not just you.
In the center of the ring, Bryan Danielson and Minoru Suzuki stare daggers at each other.
You can feel the tension, baby!
Both men start to make advances towards each other, both men measure their strength, Suzuki takes the advantage, and Brian releases himself from the hold and works on Suzuki's hand, down to the mat, then to Suzuki's shin. Suzuki reverses and grabs Brian's neck, snapmare on Brian, Suzuki buries his knee on Brian's upper back, back to applying a hold on Brian's neck. Brian reverses into a knee bar and Suzuki breaks the hold with the help of the ropes. Brian dives on Suzuki's ankle, Suzuki blocks the dragon screw, Brian kicks Suzuki's thigh and Suzuki says, "Bring it on." Suzuki mocks Brian, Brian gives a vicious forearm to Suzuki that barely makes a dent on the king. Suzuki palm strikes Brian, Brian answers with a round kick, Suzuki with another palm strike catching Brian in the mouth. Brian with another round kick that causes Suzuki to take several steps back, absorbing the impact into the corner area. Suzuki coils his elbow and...
he's just ready. Like, just get, do it. Oh, no!
Brian manages to recover from the brutal forearm and goes on the offense with kicks to Suzuki's chest and Suzuki's thighs. Snapmare, hammer and anvil strikes on Suzuki, Brian looks for his submission move, the cattle mutilation. Suzuki forces the break, Brian continues to strike Suzuki, Suzuki puts Brian in the jujigatami, action spills to the outside as both men strike each other. Face first goes Brian into the ring post, Suzuki takes a walk on the outside, security dude twice the size of Suzuki looks concerned. Back in the ring, Suzuki awaits for Brian, Brian punches Suzuki's gut, Suzuki with a knee to Brian's face, Suzuki works on Brian's upper back, and Suzuki with the hammerlock on Brian. Suzuki manipulates Brian's wrist and forces Brian to break the hold on the rope. Back outside the ring goes the fight, Suzuki punches Brian, Brian reverses sending Suzuki to the ring post, Brian flies with a running knee strike on Suzuki's face, back in the ring again the action goes. Suzuki dares Brian to strike him and sadistically Minoru Suzuki takes it, almost goes down but not quite. Second shot hits Suzuki but still Suzuki won't go down, third strike, fourth strike and only the fifth strike manages to take Suzuki down. Brian manages to capture Suzuki's arm, Brian punishes Suzuki with some vicious stomps on Suzuki's neck followed by a bridge submission. Still, Suzuki won't go down. Pinfall attempt, Suzuki kicks out a two. Action spills to the corner, thunderous knife head chops and kicks to Suzuki's chest, flying shot in the corner, still Suzuki is in the fight. Another vicious knife ass chop on Suzuki, Irish whip reversal, Suzuki with a kick on the corner, snapmare, and Suzuki punts Brian's chest. Brian powers through in a remarkable example of fighting spirit. Suzuki repays Brian with another kick, Brian powers through again, third strike takes out Brian, pinfall attempt, and Suzuki pays back the American Dragon with some stomps of his own. Back to a vertical base, Brian and Suzuki uppercut and forearm each other. Brian attempts a suplex, Suzuki reverses into a submission looking for the Fujiwara armbar, Brian's foot breaks the hold in the ropes and Suzuki stomps on Brian. The referee gets pushed out of the way, Suzuki returns to Brian, Brian takes out Suzuki, attempting to engage the lapel lock on Suzuki. Suzuki masterfully rolls his body, breaking the hold with his feet on the ropes. Time for some forearms, both men strike each other, Suzuki with his hands behind his back, offers Brian his neck to hit. Brian strikes Suzuki with vicious intent, Suzuki's face tells a story of the massive blow he sustains at the hands of Brian, the second strike lands, then the third strike manages to shake Suzuki, but still, Suzuki is in the fight. The fourth strike still doesn't do it, Suzuki takes Brian for a forearm, Brian knows what's coming, it ain't pretty. Suzuki continues his onslaught of violence, as does Brian. Brian swings and misses, both men take each other out with stereo slaps. Both wrestlers manage to get back to a vertical base, selling the damage both men have put each other through. Neither man quits, and a kick to Suzuki's chest. Suzuki shows some fatigue, Brian attempts to capitalize, Suzuki follows, sleeper hold, Brian reverses, back to the sleeper hold goes Brian. Brian reverses, Brian attempts to to put Suzuki in a submission hold. Suzuki escapes and attempts the God-style pile driver. Bryan sends Suzuki flying back first into the canvas, knee to the chest. Bryan gains some momentum off the ropes. Suzuki follows. Bryan with a knee takes out Suzuki. Pinfall for the win, and Bryan Danielson wins his match. Such good shit.
What a war!
Thank you for watching this trip down memory lane. If I missed anything, please let me know in the comments below. Feel free to press that like button and also subscribe for more future content just like this, or better. This has been fun. Thank you for watching.